One way to find a verse in the Bible is to use the table of contents. The table of contents is at the very beginning of the Bible, and it's split into two sections, the Old Testament and the New Testament. The word testament means promise. There are 39 books in the Old Testament. The Old Testament books tell the story of the promise God made. There are 27 books in the New Testament. The New Testament books tell the story of how God's promise came true. Today, we're reading a verse from this book of the Bible. It's in the New Testament. Did you find it? There is a page number next to the book to help you find where it is in the Bible. Go ahead and turn there. Books of the Bible are divided into chapters and verses that are numbered. Once you've found the book of the Bible, then it's time to find the chapter. That's the big number. And the verse, those are the little numbers. Are you ready to find our verse for today? Let's all turn to it now.
Today we're reading Ephesians 5, 8 through 11. I hope you found it because we're jumping right in. If you haven't, that's okay too. You can always follow along on the screen. But it says, "For you were once darkness, but now you are the light in the Lord. Live as children of light, for the fruit of the light consists in all goodness, righteousness, and truth. And find out what pleases the Lord. Have nothing to do with the fruitless deeds of darkness, but rather expose them." Verse 10 says to find out what pleases the Lord, because God is a creator. He loves when we create too. I want you to think back to the first time you brought home an art project you made at school. It probably wasn't the best art in the world, but it probably looked a little something like this. But you were definitely proud of it, and you wanted to put it on display. And although there are some pretty famous art galleries and museums all over the world, like the Louvre in Paris or the Museum of Modern Art in New York City, as a little kid, the most exclusive gallery in the world was your refrigerator. I don't know about you, but I loved seeing something I made hanging up on the fridge. I was proud of myself for making it, and it felt like my family was proud of me too. I know that's such a small example of creativity, but I want to use it to teach you this. So go ahead and write this down. Creativity connects us with others. When we create something, it connects us to God, the original creator. It also connects us to ourselves because we get to connect with our imagination and bring our ideas to life. And it connects us to others when we share our creation for them to enjoy. You got that? So this week, I want you to create something. You can paint something, make an amazing sandwich, solve a problem, clean your room in a new way. Creativity isn't just for artists, and don't worry about making it perfect. Just have fun creating something because it connects you to God and the world around you.